Hi guys, good morning, happy 2017. So for this blog post, I thought I'd do something different today. I wanted to do something where I shared with you my TNT patterns. So basically for me, a TNT pattern is something that I've made more than two times of. So a little bit of a background story. When I started sewing and I realized how many sewing patterns are out there, I actually had told myself that I was never gonna sew a pattern more than once because there were so many things that I was interested in doing. But there's some patterns that I've just made and I've just loved them enough to want to keep coming back to them. And that's what I want to talk about today with you. So let's get started. Okay, the first one that I want to share with you is Sewer Holy Grapefruit. If you follow my blog, you know that I've made this top about six times already. And the ones that I have here so far. See the first one that I made? Yes, this was my first. So a holy grapefruit. So it comes in different variations. It's got a cowl neck, and I love the cowl neck version, and I make a lot of the cowl neck version. So I made this in a jersey top. So this one was number one. I cut a size 4. I didn't have to make any alterations to it, and that's why I love this pattern so much. Not a single alteration to it, and it fits me perfectly. And this was my second one. For the second one, I decided to go with a stripy version. And these get worn so much, especially in winter, because I layer them under everything, under anything and everything, really. Okay, this is a more recent one that I made in a neutral color. Yep. And I had to do the cuffs in a different color because I ran out of the fabric. And that's that one. So those are the cowl neck versions. So I've got three cowl neck versions. And then I've made this in a John Calder fabric. And this is a round neck version with 3/4 sleeve length. So this, I made this from scrap fabric left over from another project. But I love this so much. And I've got this one in polka dots, which I don't wear often, but it's a really cute top nonetheless. So this is a bit more drapier poly viscose fabric. And another, oh no, sorry, so that makes it four cowl neck versions. And this one is in a round neck, and this fabric, I think I bought it from Fabworks. But yeah, what I love about this pattern is it's got cuffs, so you don't have to do any hemming. And it's got a hem bend, so you don't have to do any hemming at all. And it's really, really fast to make. It takes up very little fabric. And I can make this in less than an hour and a half from cutting it out to sewing it up because I do it on the overlocker. And lastly, but not least, the number 7 is this little cardigan hack that I made from the Renfrew top. So I just basically cut it down the center front. And then I added a band, and I was going to put some buttons on it, but I just never bothered with it. But yeah, I quite like that. So that's number one. So highly recommend the Sewer Holy Grapefruit top. It comes in different variations. I still have to make the V neck, which I haven't done before, so I'll be making that soon. Okay, next one is Vogue V1440, which is a Donna Karan pattern. Unfortunately, it's out of print now, but you might be able to find it on eBay or something like that. But when this pattern first came out, I fell for it straight away, and I was like, I'm getting this. And I did, because what I loved about it was it has this triangular yoke at the back. I'm sorry, you can hear my children in the background, because they're not at school today, so yeah. okay, so this has got a triangular yoke, and I love that. And it's like a sleeveless thingy, and it has a, let me just get this off the hanger so I can show it to you. And it has a concealed button placket, and this was my first time ever making a concealed button placket. And this was actually the first shirt I ever made, and it was my first time doing a collar, and I don't think I did too bad. I made it in linen, and this was a toile, but it became a wearable toile. And I love this so much. I even did this funny thing with the hem, where I cut off a bias strip in a contrasting fabric, and I did the hem with a bias strip. But a lot of love went into making this top. So that was number one of it. And I made a second one in a purple quilting cotton, but I've given that one away now because it was just a little bit too tight on the bust because the fabric had no give in it whatsoever because it was a quilting cotton. And I didn't know that when I bought it because I just loved the color. It was a beautiful purple magenta. And I still need to make one in a beautiful purple magenta, but except in proper shirting cotton instead of quilting cotton. Okay, and then the other one, the third one that I made was in this ditzy mustard print, which I just really liked again. And I made it, you know, a mandarin collar instead of putting the collar band. And I love this. I wear this with leggings and jeans in summer. You can't really see the triangular yoke so much on this one, but you know, it's a really beautiful feature. And I also made it in cotton lawn. I love working with cotton lawn. And I used a Czech cotton lawn, and yeah, I just really like it. Again, I did a mandarin collar because I actually quite like it in the mandarin collar version. So yeah, I'll put links down below for some blog articles, but yeah, I love this stuff. So I've made four of these. I'm going to make another one this summer as well in I think some Liberty Tanner lawn. Yay. Okay, moving on. Oh, this is my absolute favorite. Oh, it's my absolute favorite. Kame shirt dress. It's a Pauline Alice pattern. I think she's Spanish. But yeah, she does like these really cute, gorgeous vintage style patterns. And this was the first pattern that I bought from her. And it's also one of the things that I made in my first year of proper sewing. So I started off by making this Kame blouse in a cotton. It's a lightweight cotton fabric. And it's just beautiful. It's cotton hearts in gray, and I decided to go with a contrasting white bib thingy. I love the pin tucks that it has on there. And this pattern, it has a video sew along, so I followed the video sew along, and I love patterns that have video sew alongs because I'm a very visual person. I mean, I can do the reading thing, but I prefer video sew alongs because they're so much more thorough, and I can get like an exact idea of what to do. So I love it. And I love the mandarin collar. And for the buttons, I shopped around for heart shaped buttons, and yeah, I really, really like it. So that was the first one that I made. The second one that I made, I entered into the pattern review sewing bee. I think it was in, yes, it was. And I made it in linen, in a navy blue linen. So I had to dye the linen, and then I did some sashiko embroidery on the bib front, but I took off the placket and I finished it off with a bias binding. And I also created a yoke on the back to do some sashiko embroidery on it. And I loved doing this. I just really loved doing this. And it's such a great, great casual top that I wear a lot in summer and spring. Oh, and for the bib on the inside, what I did to protect the sashiko embroidery, I covered it up with a silk fabric that I harvested from a top that I picked up at Car Booty. But I just thought that worked really well. And I think, what did I do with it? Yes, I love that. I like the splashes of color. Okay, so that was another. And these two I made last year for Indie Pattern Month. And I used, this was an old tablecloth that I bought at Car Boot sale for like 50p or something. And it had just been sitting around, and I had these ideas about what to do with it. And I just thought, oh, this would actually be perfect. And you know, this is a quilting cotton, so it's a little bit stiffer than what I would like, but again, this works really quite well. And yeah, I just love that one. And finally, Kame number four is this roses one with a cornflower blue placket, and I love the pin tuck detail again. And yeah, so it is a great pattern. I really love this, and I still want to make more of these. I definitely want to make more of these, and I think this summer I'm going to be making another one in like a pale light blue linen. Okay, next up is lady skater dress, which is such a cute little dress. When I bought it at first, I wasn't too sure whether it would be suitable for me being a mummy and all that, but I love it. It's very sporty and kind of sexy. And here we go. I made my first one in a scuba. It was my first time working with scuba, and I was very scared of it because I just thought, oh, what's going to happen? But you know, I just dug in. I stuck into it and I did it, and I love it. And the nice thing about the scuba is it still looks really, really good. And this is almost 2 years old, but I still wear this a lot, and it still maintained its elasticity. So this was the first one that I made. The second one that I made last year, I used a very simple jersey viscose in peacock colors, which I really like bright jewel colors, and I did a cap sleeve version this time around, which I wasn't too sure about, but it turned out it works quite well on me, and it's just a really cute, sassy, little, sexy dress. And I would love to make this in black or in navy blue, because I think it would make a really cute little black dress. Okay, you might recognize the fabric. I used the leftover fabric to make a Sewaholic Renfrew top, and I quite like that the Renfrew, normally I can squeeze one out of scrap fabric. So that's Lady Skater number 2, and then Lady Skater number 3 is my absolute favorite. I made this in December, and honest to this dress is fabulous. I mean, it looks great on me. I have to do a vlog post for this, and that will follow, but this is, I love this dress. It's so cute. I wear it with long boots, and yeah. Oh, I did adapt it from a scoop neck to a higher slash neck, because I wanted it to be suitable for, you know, for winter, so that I could wear it by itself for winter. So that's Lady Skater, highly recommended pattern, very good instructions that come with it. Yeah, the next one is my Holly Byrne skirt. I love the Holly Byrne. It is so easy to sew, such an incredibly flattering fit, and honestly, I think you could make, I could make 100 of these and still not be satisfied. So I have made so many of them. I've given one away though, because I can't remember what, my friend really, really, really liked it, and she was like, oh, please, can I have it? And I was like, okay, fine, if you really like it, then you can have it. Okay, so where's the first one that I ever made? Oh, actually, I've given two away, because the first one that I made was a denim one, but I think I got the size too big, because I cut out a size 6, but it was a bit too big, and then I sized down to a 4 with this one, and that was just the perfect size for me. So this is, let's put you over here. This is the first one, no, the second one that I made, and it's a, I don't know, some sort of a mustardy fabric that I bought from B&M Fabrics. And I put in a lot of effort into this, because I even lined it, which I hadn't really been doing until then, but it's got a very lovely, luxurious feel to it. And I put in an invisible zipper. So, and I love this. I wear this a lot with, especially with roll necks. I love it with roll necks, but yeah, it's a perfect winter staple. Okay, so this one is number one. The next one that I made was, let's get you out. So it comes in 3 views. So you can get one which is sort of short and more flared, and something, and another one which is just beyond knee length with a bit less flare, and then like a midi version with even less flare, which is more like an A-line skirt. I've never made the midi version. I've always sort of alternated between the shorter one and the knee length one. So this is a shorter one, and I made this in a really thick crepe like fabric, which is very, very warm. I wanted, you know, just a foundation piece for my wardrobe. And yeah, this one is very cute, very sassy. I used a contrasting fabric for the waistband. I didn't line this one because it was quite a heavy fabric, and I bias bound the hem because it's a circular skirt, so it's a bit narky to thing. But yeah, I really, really like this skirt. It gets worn a lot in winter. And then I made this one, which is my all-time favorite Holly Byrne skirt. It's made in bark cloth, and I made it for Indie Pattern Month, and I put in so much effort into making this. So because it was bark cloth and I wanted to preserve the pattern, I eliminated the center front seam and I just cut it on the fold. Okay, and yeah, and I didn't do the pockets, the hip pockets. I did some side seam pockets. So it's got the pockets on the side seam with some back lining on it. And then in order to get it to hold its shape up, because back cloth, it's quite a heavy fabric, so it tends to sort of drop with gravity, I lined it with two layers of tulle. But this is a lightweight tulle with some drape to it, not that stiff dress net stuff that you find in most shops, the one that sort of like sticks out straight. So you can see that this one, you know, it still drapes, but it's got a very subtle effect. It holds it up. I should do a video where I'm wearing this, actually, because it's one of my favorite. And I finished off the hem with like a red bias binding. I really love the detail that I put into it. And then I lined it as well with this lovely cupro lining, and I put in a petersham ribbon, which makes it so incredibly comfortable in the waist. Plus, because back cloth is very, very thick and bulky, I wanted to reduce bulk at the waistline. That's why I used the petersham ribbon. But it's so incredibly comfortable, easily the most comfortable skirt that I have, and I love it. So yeah, I could go on talking about this skirt forever. Okay, the next one that I made is a denim one, and I love this. I put in an exposed zipper for the first time ever. I used an orange cupro lining for the waistband. I didn't line it because it's denim, and I used a lovely contrasting stripy fabric for the pocket lining, because that's the other fun thing that I like about the Hollyburns, that I get to play around with the pocket lining detail. But yeah, this one is a great staple that gets worn quite a lot, and it goes with just about everything. I'm still to find something that doesn't go with it. And I did my favorite finish on circle skirts, which is the bias bound. I used a gray satin bias binding for the hem. Okay, so that's that one. And then lastly, the most recent Hollyburn that I made is this red linen one. So this is a shorter version, but yeah, I love this linen, this embroidered linen fabric. Again, I eliminated the center front seam on this one, and it's very easy to eliminate the center front seam. You just draw in the 5/8 inch seam allowance, fold it under, and then you use that for your fold line. And I lined it with some red acetate, just some cheap red acetate thing, and I used for the waistband, because it's got these holes in it, I couldn't just put interfacing straight on, so I had to interface a piece of red muslin cloth, and then also use some red muslin cloth on the waistband so that it's got a nice neat finish. Yeah, so very, very happy with this. So Hollyburn skirt, highly recommended. And I've got plans to make some more. I think I've got another one cut out ready to be sewn up this summer, so I love that. Okay, next, after that one, let me show you my Monettes. I love Monette because it was the first knit dress that I ever made. This is the first one that I made, and I still wear this. I mean, granted, I don't really go out with it. It's more like a around the house kind of thing now. But when I first made this, I was still breastfeeding my twins, so my bust was much, much bigger. So it is a little bit big now on me, but I still love it and I still wear it. So that was the first Monette that I made. Second Monette that I made is this color blocked version in blue with a black roll collar, and I love this. This still looks so fantastic on me. And yeah, I mean, my elastic application was still quite dodgy. That was that's the tricky thing with the Monette, sort of figuring out how to do the shearing. I didn't do too bad a job, but if you look closely, you can see that it is a little. Next up is this Monette in John Caldo fabric, and I love this Monette because it's John Caldo. It's a very comfortable fabric. It's very beautiful and vibrant colors, purples and mustards and aubergine. And I made this version with a roll neck version, and I did short sleeves because I wanted enough fabric to make another t-shirt, which I did. And yeah, so on this one, I, for the first time ever, it only took me 4 tries, I nailed the elastic shearing on this. So I really, really quite like it. Monette, another highly recommended pattern for me. The only adjustment that I made to that one was I added an inch to the bodice because it was a little bit too high up when I make the first one. It also comes with a free pack that has got something like 6 color variations. Oh gosh, I forgot another moneta. I got one more, which is a Peter Pan collar in red. I'll need to find that, film that, and splice it in. Okay, right, I'm moving on to my other favorite shirt dresses of all time from Green Line Studios, Aldi shirt dress. I've made 4 of these, and I really, really like it. I've got plans to make more. I've got a Liberty tunnel on put aside for another one in summer. So this was the first one that I ever made, and it's in cotton lawn that I bought from B&M Fabrics, and it's navy blue with white palm trees and flamingos, and I really, really like this. It is so comfortable. I wear it a lot in summer, and oh gosh, I love it so much that I monogrammed it when I made it. I don't know if that's possible to see, but yeah, I did. I put a little H there for Hila, but it's my finest stitching work here. I mean, I'm seriously showing off now, but this is the collar, and it's fabulous, and this has been washed so many times, but it is still looking good. The fabric holds up really well. The second one that I made was a bum ruffle version. So the shirt dress comes in 2 versions, one that's straight down like what I just showed you, or you can make it with a bum ruffle, which has got a gathered back and sides. And this is a John Calder fabric that I bought from Minerva Fabrics online. I loved the teals, the sage, and the navy blue, and yeah, I made this one. I made some covered buttons for the first time ever. I didn't know about the thingamajiggy that you use for covering those buttons, so I did this by hand, and they took me forever to make, but with the next one that I made, I used, I bought the button cover thing, which is highly, highly recommended, because you don't need to waste your time doing it by hand like I did, which was really, really silly. But yes, this is the second one that I made. I love this. It's, the color has faded somewhat, but it's still very wearable, anyway, but the collar looks a little bit worse for wear, but never mind. I've got a lot of wear out of this. Okay, and then the third one that I made using a fabric that was considered a very precious fabric for me. It's Nani Iro. I don't know if I pronounced that right. I think, yeah, but yeah, if it is Japanese, it would be Nani Iro, because Japanese is quite phonetic. So yes, it's Nani Iro. So it's a Nani Iro poncho fabric, and this had been sitting in my stash for a really long time. I bought 1.5 meters of it, so I managed to squeeze this out of 1.5 meters, and I love this. Okay, I love this so much. I'm just gonna put it on. Oh, I love double gauze pattern, double gauze fabric. It's really, really lovely to wear, and I made self-covered buttons. And I had the button thingy for this. I don't know what it's called, that's why I keep calling it the button thingy for it. But yeah, it's just really cute. And I used some cotton and steel scrap fabric for the inside of the collar, and I made it a mandarin collar. And I love this. I wear it with, I have a little pink belt that I wear it with, and it's so cute. This is one of my favorites. And then I also recently made, I think there's a video link for this one, and I'll show you too. It's a bum ruffle dress in a chambray denim fabric, and oh, it's so cute. I mean, there is something about this shirt dress pattern that I love, 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 love so much. So yeah, I think what I'll try next time when I make this, because I will make this again, is I will try and put some pockets, some side seam pockets, because I feel like it's really perfect, but that's the only thing that's missing from it, some pockets, because I do love pockets in dresses. Okay, so that's the Aldi shirt dress pattern done. Okay, so what shall I show you next? Okay, I'll show you some dresses next, okay? Giselle, there is a small American independent company called Kate and Rose Patterns, and I saw this Giselle pattern, Giselle maxi dress pattern, and I really liked it. And this was the first one that I made. I used a jersey interlock, which I think was quite unusual for the dress, but yeah, and it's got this very interesting yoke detail, and I put this bias binding on. So funny story about this, right? It was my first time trying to finish a neckline with bias binding and I did it completely wrong. This wasn't actually supposed to be visible. It was actually supposed to be inside like that, but you live and learn, right? So, you know, I just left it like that rather than cut it off and start again and mess it up. But yeah, I quite like this. I still wear this a lot. So it's got a belt. So the idea is that you put it on and then you tie it up and you've got a fitted waist and it's very, very comfortable. Okay, so that was number one. The second one that I made was for Independent Month and I used this cotton lawn, gorgeous, bright, colorful cotton lawn. I made it sleeveless and I made version A, which is an Empire line dress, and I love it. And I decided to do this in a contrasting black line and it works. And I always think that, you know, this would make a really nice skirt as well. I could make a skirt out of this. But yeah, really, really like this dress. Wear it a lot. And then this one is my favorite Giselle dress. It's linen and it's navy blue. No, this one was this was jeans blue. I dyed this a jeans blue because I do a lot of dyeing actually. I should talk about that more. But yeah, so this one was in linen. And yeah, and I love the details that I put in. So I did some decorative stitching along the neckline and I used a colorful bias binding along the neckline. You can see this time I did it correctly. It's gone in correctly this time around. And these are called flat filled seams over there. And I did the same decorative stitching on the sleeves. And for the hem, I did three lines of the decorative stitching, making it smaller and smaller in mustard. So I love the detail on this dress and I love it. I love it when I'm wearing it, I sort of like I swish around when I'm walking. So yeah, it's highly recommended. I'm not sure that they do paper patterns though. I think it's just PDF patterns, okay? Another dress that I have to show you is the By Hand London Anna dress. And I think this is an incredibly popular pattern, but I love this pattern. This pattern makes me feel like a queen, like all that's missing is a tiara for me to swan around in. So the first one that I made was this, in this beautiful crepe fabric that I got from Fabworks. And oh my gosh, this is so fabulous. It is one of my favorite dresses. And it's got this thigh-high slit. It's a highly recommended pattern for me. It's very easy to sew. And I made three of these. This was the second one that I made, which is in this beautiful blue color. And I made the V-neck version on this one. And yeah, the third one, I made it in a viscose fabric and I gave that to my sister because my sister saw it and she said, oh, I like that. And I said, okay, well, if you like it, you can have it because I can always make myself another one. So unfortunately, I can't show you the third one, but I've already, in fact, a couple of days ago, I cut out another one, which is for my swap 2017. So yeah, so I've saved the best for last, okay, because I love the Sewaholic Granville top and I have made so many of them. This is one of my favorite patterns. It's the perfect fitting shirt pattern for me and I love sewing with it. In fact, I have cut out another Sewaholic Granville top ready and waiting to be sewn up when I find the time to go into my sewing cave. Okay, so the first one that I made was a sleeveless blue one in chambray. And because it's light blue, it goes with just about everything and I wear it a lot. It was actually a muslin, a toile, a trial garment, because you can see I didn't even bother finishing the seam, but it turned out to be wearable and I wear it quite a lot actually. Right, and then the next one that I made, I used a cotton poplin fabric, so it's slightly thicker and slightly warmer, so I tend not to be able to wear this that much in summer because it does get very warm very quickly, but it's very soft as well. But I love this color. This was before I ever bought Liberty fabric because I just thought this looks a little bit like Liberty, but it's not as expensive. And yeah, so this was my second Sewaholic Granville and I really, really like that. My third one was another floral one. Now, this was a fabric that I bought on eBay, and I had no idea what the content is. But yeah, so I made this one. I did flat filled seams, so it's very, very well tailored. Let's see if I can show them to you. So you can see how neat they are. And I even did them on the side seams. I didn't manage to do them on the sleeves. But yeah, and you know, I'm very proud of the plackets that I did. And yeah, it's just such a, I love this. It's so bright, it's so cheerful. I wear this a lot in summer and in spring. And I also made this one. It's a cotton lawn fabric and it's a blue paisley. And I love paisley. And it's lightweight. Oh, I really, really like it. It's one of, actually, I'm showing you all of these are kind of like my favorites. By default, they're my favorites because I've made them so many times and I still want to make them again. So if I keep repeating myself, it's because I really, really like them. Okay, so, yeah, so this is granville number 1, 2, 3, 4. Granville number 4, okay? And then granville number 5 is this cotton one in autumnal colors. So I wanted an autumnal style granville, and I thought, oh, these colors, this fabric was in my stash. And so I just thought, no, this could work. And what I did differently with this one was I used poppers instead of buttons because I thought it would be faster, but it wasn't. Maybe it's because I didn't have the correct tools or something like that, but it didn't. It actually took me longer to put these in than to put buttons in. So yeah, I wasn't too impressed with that at all. I also did contrasting cuffs using fabric that was left over from this one. See? And that's the thing I love about sewing myself is that I can do like really quirky things like this. And yeah, it's quite nice. But okay, so that's the last one. And for this one, I did what are called fake flat felt seams. So I still finished it with an overlocker, press it, and then I just top stitch it. So it looks like a flat filled seam from the outside, but on the inside it's not actually a flat filled seam. So yeah, so that does that. Thank you so much for watching. I know that was a lot to cover, but it was quite fun picking out all of my tried and true favorite patterns and just talking about them with you. Do you guys have any tried and true patterns? If you do, then just please share with me in the comments down below. And I hope you've enjoyed this. And if you did, then please hit the like button down below. And I'll be seeing you guys later. Bye!